Let's understand the process of bank loan. There are many people who wish to set up their own business or buy a car, a house or some asset. The list can be long. However, not every has money on hand. This is when people approach banks to discuss and take loans. The amount could vary from a few thousands to a few lakhs. Let's consider someone has taken a loan of rupees 50,000 from the bank. With this loan, the person sets up his small business. Now every month this person has to return a certain amount plus some interest that has been agreed with the bank. You remember we discussed that saving with a bank earns interest on a monthly basis. Now considering a loan taken from a bank, we have to pay an interest to the bank. This is the opposite of earning a profit. Let me explain this further. How does the bank manage to pay interest to its account holders? The difference between what is charged from borrowers and what is paid to depositors is the bank's main source of income. People have various needs and desires, and they don't always have sufficient money to fulfill these needs. Banks are an institution that helps people with the required finances. A person who takes a loan from the bank must meet certain prerequisites such as agree to the rate of interest, commit to an undertaking to return the loan as well as the interest within the stipulated period. Now there are two types of credit situations. In the first situation, a person borrows money for establishing a business or production with the promise to repay the loan at the end of the year when the production work is complete. At the end of the year, the person makes a good profit and is able to repay the loan amount with the interest. In the second situation, a person borrows money from the bank and at the end of 1 year has not earned any profits. Instead, he has experienced losses. Now he is unable to return the loan and the interest amount to the bank at the end of the year. He comes under a debt trap. We all know that a loan taken requires a few prerequisites. One of them is providing a collateral. A collateral could be any asset of value such as gold, ornaments, jewelry against which a loan can be borrowed. Why a collateral? If the borrower after taking the loan absconds, the bank will face a loss. Once the borrower has repaid the loan with the agreed rate of interest within the period of time, the asset held as collateral is returned to the borrower. Formal and informal sector. There are two sources of credit in an economy. The formal sector and the informal sector. Both these sectors are very different from each other. Let us discuss. The formal sector includes banks and cooperatives which follow standard set of rules and processes. Their rate of interest is also fixed based on the different types of loans. The norms followed by all banks across India have been set by the Reserve Bank of India. The informal sector includes taking loans from friends, relatives, employers and lenders. This informal sector does not have a fixed range for the rate of interest. Lenders decide the rate of interest depending on factors they would like to consider. Hence, the interest rate variation is wide. The next topic: money lenders. What does that mean? Let me tell you. Do you think we have banks in the remote and rural areas of India? No. Yet there are many people from the rural areas who need finances to meet some needs. They too take loans, however not from banks, as there are no banks in these areas. So the villagers take loan from local money lenders for agriculture, etc. We know that taking a bank loan requires us to submit documents and identity cards. These money lenders do not ask for similar documentation. Since the villagers know each other well, they get the loan. However, the borrower has to pay a higher rate of interest for such loans from local money lenders. Self-help groups. There is another source of credit that rural India can benefit from: the self-help groups. These are set up by the local villagers, and the rate of interest on the borrowed capital is lower than a bank or the private money lenders. This is encouraging for the local villagers. The villager meet their financial needs and are safe from debt traps. These groups have 15 to 20 who contribute towards a capital sum, which is then used as lending to each other for a minimum rate of interest. The borrower in this scenario is not burdened with repaying a heavy principal amount plus the interest. The loan is repaid within the period agreed upon. These are the important sources of credit.